The Noongar Native Title Indigenous Land Use Agreement has just been registered from the National Native Title Tribunal regarding the Noongar ILUA, Indigenous Land Use Agreement of the Southwest of Noongar Country, WA, where we have surrendered and relinquished all rights to land. This Noongar Indigenous Land Use Agreement that was just authorised and signed off by the National Native Title Tribunal was not an agreement between the 35,000 Noongar people and anyone else and the Land Council and that, with between the Land Council. This agreement was done between the Land Council, state government, and at the influence of big mining companies in Western Australia. We have relinquished and surrendered our rights to land. It's corruption. No matter how you look at it, from the highest levels down, it's utter corruption that our people have surrendered and relinquished our rights to land, being the oldest culture and people in the world, being my First Nations people, the Noongar people, and other clan groups across Australia. We have been dictated to and corruptly, without the consent and authorisation of all our people, relinquished and surrendered our birthrights to our Noongar country in the southwest of Western Australia. It is a very sad time for our people, and it's a very sad time for Australia, and especially for the First Nations people, for a clan group to have to surrender and relinquish their rights to country for an economic base, like we have done, that we have done now, and you know, in the dictatorship of the West Australia government and our Land Council, we are at a stage where they say our Noongar people have surrendered all our rights to country without the authorisation of the people. This was a deal done between government and our Land Council. They done the deal. No matter what, we was told at an early stage, no matter what you say, this deal is going through. So that tells me, yes, it has gone through, but this deal was from the highest levels down, dictated and authorised by state government, South West Land and Sea Council, our Noongar Land and Sea Council, which is federally funded body. They were not representative of our people, and we believe mining companies had a huge influence on the Noongar Indigenous Land Use Agreement.